Basically, we registered as Team Axis. We were a four-member team. One of us was Vishal Pawar, his brother Santosh Pawar, then Dr. Anand Gangwal, and myself, Aashish Joshi. Vishal and Santosh have been ex-pro riders. Anand is attempting his first Ironman, and I am into long-distance riding. So that was basically the composition of riders. We had an excellent crew. The crew chief, we used to call him. He is a merchant navy guy. So he was all about safety strategies, and basically a lot of weightage was given to planning. We had documents hanging in the car, what was each person's role, what had to be done, right up to the minutest detail as which side of the car that person was supposed to get out from in terms of safety. So none of us was allowed to get out of the car from the right side of the road. Everybody had to alight from the left side. Then we had a proper planning done for the cycle management, because since we were four riders, which cycle is to be hung where, so that easy access to that cycle for the next rider was easily available. So lot of strategies were done on that. Then another nice thing that was done, we had a recce done on the same route. So we knew how the terrain was, where we were going to have some issues in terms of finding the right route or road, because there were a couple of points which were slightly confusing. So we had been to that place, so that was also covered in our recce. Then a lot of attention was given to the food management, but unfortunately it didn't work for us. I mean, because of the adrenaline rush and the event, the mood it caught up, and we actually forgot to have the right type of nutrition at the right time. But it was fun, it was a part of that event. Most of the planning that we had done really went well, apart from couple of two in terms of the riding pull or turns that we had planned, but we didn't do it that way, because one of our riders, he had some stomach issues at Mahabaleshwar, Vishal, and so he was not feeling well after Mahabaleshwar, but by the time we reached Belgaon, Kolhapur rather, he had recovered slightly, so he took his turn after Kolhapur. Otherwise, rest of the things really went as per the plan. One of our riders, he didn't have that kind of exposure to the night riding, but since some slight changes had to be done to take into account the tiredness of the riders who were actually doing the pull in the guard sections, they also participated very enthusiastically, and we managed to cover that route in the given targeted time. We had targeted something below 24 hours, and luckily we managed well within that time. Race experience wise, we could say, since it was our first time as a team together, riding together, first time in a race environment, because for us, for me myself, I've been doing a lot of BRM, so there's no such pressure about timings and all. We know we have to reach from a point A to point B in a particular time, but there's no pressure of pushing yourself to your limit or something like that. But over here, it was like doing intervals. So every rider who is to take his turn was practically doing an interval of that allotted distance, so maybe 20 kilometers, 30 kilometers, whatever, based on the terrain what we had planned. So he was doing an interval, so it was right from word go, it was flat out to the time the next person would take his pull. So that was an extremely different experience. Recovering in the short time available and then getting on the cycle again was another different challenge, and we had basically tried to train our body for that also. In our training rides, what we used to do is we used to go flat out, probably maybe the training ride used to be from Pune to Khambatki and back. So flat out from Pune right up to Shirwai, then purposefully halting there for half an hour and allowing or making the body to cool down, and then again trying to attempt another flat out turn till Khambatki. So that was how we tried to train the body, because normally your body is warm, you can do a different, it's in the rhythm. Over here, we plan to break the rhythm and try to get into rhythm again. So that was something that we had trained for, and it really worked for us. Otherwise, it would have been difficult to do those intervals without, recovery time being very less, and those challenges we would have faced. But luckily, we had trained ourselves for that. So that was something different. Then riding in the night, yeah, in Chorla was an awesome experience. The visibility was really low. It was extremely foggy. And the biggest challenge over there was the idea was to ride in the lights from our vehicle provided by the car. So we had very powerful lights on the car. But because of the terrain and the speed that the cycle was being able to deliver, it was very difficult for the support car to keep up with that pace because it was very dangerous. Because of the turns, and there was a fear that they would get too close to the rider and in turn might end up hitting him. So that was a bigger challenge. So at times it so happened that though the cycle could deliver that pace, we had to slow down to keep the safety factor into account. Saw a couple of jackals in the ghat section. So that was another thing, something different. So then luckily during the ghat section, what happened was we had a target of another rider whom we had sighted. So it was from Team Saimor. And so basically what happened because of that was right from the Chorla start section till the end point, both of our teams were going side by side or just ahead of each other. And so that became a very challenging environment for both the teams. And it helps us push the bar, because otherwise we were in a comfort zone. We knew an X target was to be achieved, and we were targeting for that. But because of that competition, it helped us to achieve even better timing than what we had set out for. And also it took away the complacency, because we were kind of getting into a comfort zone, and that helped us. So both the teams, after we finished the race, we had a nice chat on that with the Saimor team also, and they also were of the same opinion, and it really made that particular section, which was at the end of the race, we were all tired, and it brought in some fun factor into that. And they had this nice music going on with a loud speaker put up on their car, so we were riding on those very high pitched tunes, so it was fun. And the biggest the final moment of that ride was the final 10 kilometers after we entered Goa. And it was like a movie scene with our car, half of the crew outside the car, leaning outside the windows and literally shouting behind my back to push. And it was like some movie scene where the villains have got their swords out of the car and they are running after the hero, something like that. So because of that, the adrenaline was too high, and we could there was some distance between our team and the Saimor's team at that point of time, but we managed to cover that entire distance, and probably only a minute's difference was what was there at the end. That was a real something that I will always remember, something filmy.